All right, here we go. Thank you, and background action.
The tech is amazing because it allows you to do things that even if you were on location, you couldn't control to that degree.
Action.
I was immediately struck by just the quality of light. As opposed to a stage with blue screens or green screens, you're immediately in that environment.
Because the second season, they built a bigger volume, it allowed the show to feel all the more epic.
I like when visual effects fool you in a way that you don't even know you were fooled.
Jon Favreau brought his vision for a new way of filmmaking, providing filmmakers with flexibility to innovate, create, collaborate, and get final pixel content in real time in a soundstage.
For season two, there was a number of areas we wanted to improve.
By the second season, ILM developed some software that was specific to this technology and to what the hardware was capable of.
Visual effects is becoming real time.
We're always developing StageCraft to get better and more powerful and more flexible.
Today, I'm particularly excited to be rolling out StageCraft 2.0. StageCraft really is an end-to-end solution.
And almost every feature that's in there now came about because of a specific filmmaker request.
Unparalleled rendering power at incredible resolution, both on the walls and on the ceiling.
We've essentially built a platform that we can continue to build upon, from scouting to virtual cameras, motion capture performance, and finally LED volume content.
So whether it's the color pipeline, or the CG rendering, or the software or the hardware, because we are bringing that whole package together with all that experience, we've been able to solve those problems quickly and get to shooting.
It also has forced us into having a more efficient workflow that draws pre-production, post-production, and production all into one continuous pipeline.
When you write and you shoot and you direct, you get so inspired by being on an actual location. That's where you come up with most of your shots. What's wonderful about this system is everyone's on the same page.
We now have the capability to grab hold of any tree in a forest, of which there are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds, and move them around independently to reset dress on the day based upon what we were seeing through the camera.
Even though the set has not been built, it's built virtually, but we're physically there, and it feels like you're really walking through the space.
It inspires the actors, inspires the filmmaker to now see what they're shooting. You know, it's like painting with the lights on, finally.
Everybody knows what something looks like, how the sequence is going to be put together, where the camera should go. It's all worked out in advance.
For me to be flying around virtually all the different locations, real and virtual, sets that we're going to build and non-sets that were just going to be on the volume with John, who's in LA and I'm in Austin, and we're going and checking it out together. It's like when we get to shooting, you're not even shooting. It feels like you're reshooting.
You can really, on the day, focus on performance and getting those shots in a really efficient way. As a director, that's what you dream about.
In the past, we would have computer models, or we would have miniatures, or sometimes we'd have photography on set. We can now take all of those things and throw them in together. We can go LiDAR something, we can go to on location and fly a drone over some mountains, and throw all of that stuff in the mix.
In addition to providing higher quality, using StageCraft can save your production money and time, because otherwise you would have to execute all of this work in a post-production period.
And there are certain shots where you have live action in the foreground, you have a miniature shoot that was texture mapped onto the geometry of a digital environment in the wall, and then in the deep background are stop motion figures that are moving around. So you have all of these different layers of techniques that all come together to hopefully feel like one combined environment, and all of it in real time.
It's mind blowing. You'll be on a set, and if you just want to change the background, or you want to get a turn around on an actor, you're not physically moving the cameras, you're actually just moving the background, and all the lights change.
Doing a French reverse, where you hit a button and the world rotates 180 degrees, it just speeds up the whole shooting process.
With the iPad, we can bring it up, we can soften it, we can make it stronger, we can move it over there in like seconds. The other great thing is that that's all saved. If we want to come back to it, we can bring it up again in seconds exactly the way it was.
You're not 100% about a background, you think you might want to add something later, you just float a blue or green screen behind them, and now they've got a perfect key and yet you're getting on the interactive lighting. It's so much faster, so much more accurate. And I mean, it really is inspiring because there it is. What you see is what you're getting.
All of these things make the volume an even more powerful tool because it can give you very accurate looks at your story the whole way up until the day where you're actually rolling on your actors.
StageCraft is incredibly efficient. We're seeing crews cover 30 or 50% more pages per day, which is an incredible improvement for the production process.
We're currently using Unreal for the design phase in the VAD and for Previs. We use Houdini, 3D Studio Max, Maya, and any best-in-class visual effects tool to create photoreal virtual environments for the volume.
Because we designed Helios from the ground up for film production, it can handle the most complex scenes and the best color fidelity. It's really the most powerful tool set that we've ever created for filmmaking.
The real power of the StageCraft team is the ability to respond on the fly to whatever fantastic demands our creative clients need.
It's less so about what StageCraft could do now. It's more about how we could push it moving forward.
In our company, you do or you don't. There is no try.
We don't have the luxury of waiting 2 quarters, 3 quarters for a piece of software. Instead, we have to be ready in weeks, sometimes days.
You have the best people in the business doing visual effects on this show and also running this technology, which is relatively new.
You can't rest on your laurels. You have to push forward and find new ways to innovate.
And the pace of innovation is at a breakneck speed, and we're not slowing down our investment in this space.
ILM is really about what have we never done before.